All right, let's go ahead and do example three. Moving on. Check it out, example three. All right, this seems fun. Let's go ahead and get into this. Let's start by labeling our A, B, and C. So again, you are responsible for knowing this information. This A is going to be 6, this B is going to be 26, and this C is going to be 8. Factor the GCF. There is no GCF in this problem. Again, don't be fooled by this. There will be problems that eventually have a GCF, and we'll talk about those later. Multiply the first terms and the last terms together. In this case, that's 6 and 8. 6 times 8. 6 times 8 is 48. So I am ending up with that. Think of the factors that multiply to give you AC. Again, that's just A times C. That's 6 times 8. And add to give B. So I'm going to go ahead and just write my factors out, essentially. I have 1. I have 48. I have 2 and 24. I have 3. And I don't actually know what that is. 16? I believe it's 16. And then I have 4. If I can write it. Oh, I hate this pen, y'all. I have 4 and 12. And then 5 doesn't go into it. And then I have 6 and 8. These are my factors for 48. So I want to find ones that add up to 26. Check it out. 2 and 24. There's a way to add that to 26. 3 and 16? Nope. 4 and 12? Nope. 6 and 8? Nope. So I am basically going with this one right here. So I know how to rewrite this. So let's rewrite this whole thing. 6x squared. 6x squared plus 2x plus 24x. Plus 8. Now, let's see. There we go. Plus 8. Now, these have multiple groupings that look like they work. So more than likely, there's more than one way to do this correctly. Do I have a way I want to do it? I'll probably group the 6x squared and the 24x together. So here I go. I'm going to rewrite this. It's going to be 6x squared plus 24x. 24x, not bad. I just made that plus sign worse. Who cares? Plus 2x plus 8. I hate this pen so much. Okay, plus 8. Okay, 6x squared plus 24x plus 2x plus 8. So I'm going to group these. This is the group I'm going with. This one and then this one. So now we have to basically factor both of those things. Here we go. Factor the binomials. So I'm going to pull out, in this case, this looks like a 6x to me. So 6x, pull that out. And I'm left with an x. And then 24 divided by 6 is a 4. And then there's no x's on this one because x and x pulls out. Now I'm going to go ahead and take out a 2 on the next one. So I have a plus 2 on this one. And then that leaves me with an x plus 4. So y'all, we basically did our work. We did it. We have this grouped. And now we have 6x plus 2. That's one group. And then the other group we have is going to be, what's it called? X plus 4. To underline the x plus 4 with red. So, right here, this is where I'm pulling out the x plus 4. Okay, that's it.